Good morning to all of you. Now we are going to start with the last chapter, that is uncertainty. Now the first point of this chapter is acting under uncertainty. Now what in by uncertainty? The agents may need to handle uncertainty, whether due to partial observability or non-deterministic or combination of the two. So it can be either a partial observability or non-deterministic or combination of the two. So here we are going to consider the uncertainty. Now when we are going to create this approach or when we are going to apply this approach, when interpreting a partial sensor information, a logical agent must consider every logical possible explanation for the observations, no matter how unlikely. Now this leads to impossible large and complex belief state representation. So here we are going to represent uncertainty. It means whenever there is a complex logic or whenever there is a complex belief state, we are saying that it is uncertain. A correct contingent plan that handles every eventually can grow arbitrarily large and must consider arbitrarily unlikely contingencies. Now here is also the contingency and there may be uncertainty. Now the next point, that is summarizing uncertainty. How we are going to make the separation of uncertainty? So we are going to see like this. Now we are considering one example of uncertain reasoning. Whenever we are diagnosing a dental patient tooth, the diagnosis will be whether for a medicine or automobile repair or whatever, almost always involves uncertainty. So here we are not going to assure that how what kind of diagnosis will be there. So there can be a simple rule, that is tooth K implies cavity. So there may be a tooth K problem in the cavity. The problem is that this rule is wrong. Not all patients with tooth K have cavities. Some of them have a gum disease and abscess or one of the several problems. So a problem can be cavity or can be gum problem or abscess or can be any problem. So this implies tooth K. Unfortunately, in order to make the rule true, we have to add an almost unlimited list of possible problems. We could try turning the rule into a causal rule. Now the causal rule is cavity implies tooth K. But this rule is not right because the problem can be gum problem also. Now trying to use the logic to cope with a domain like medicine diagnosis fails into three main reasons. First, that's laziness. It is too much work to list the complete set of antecedents or consequent needed to ensure an exceptional rule, and too hard to use such rule. Next is theoretical ignorance. Medical science has no complete theory for the domain. Next, that is practical ignorance. Even if we know all the rules, we might be uncertain about a particular patient because not all necessary tests have been or can be run. So this can be one kind of uncertainty. Now the next is uncertainty and rational decisions. To make such choice, an agent must first have preference between different possible outcomes of the various plans. So whenever we are going to make uncertainty, there can be preferences and there can be outcomes. An outcome is completely specified state, including such factors as whether the agent arrives on time or length of the wait at the airport. So we use utility theory to represent and reasons preferences. The utility of a state is relevant to an agent. For example, the utility of a state in which white has checkmated black in a game of chess is obvious high for agent playing white but low for agent playing black. So the preference as expressed by utilities are combined with probabilities in a general theory of rational decisions, that is called decision theory. Now the probability theory plus utility theory is equal to decision theory. So always decision theory implies like this. Decision theory can be the addition of probability theory and utility theory. The fundamental idea of decision theory is that an agent is rational if and only if it chooses an action that yields the highest expected utility, averaged over all possible outcomes of the action, and this is called as maximum expected utility. Now the next point we are going to talk about the basic probability notation. For our agent to represent and use probabilistic information, we need a formal language. The language of probability theory has traditionally been informed, written by human mathematician to the human math, by written by human mathematician to other human mathematician. Now this is the function how we are going to write the logic. DT agent percept is the input and return will be the action. Now this is the logic for the decision theoretic agent that select rational actions. Now what the question is, what probabilities are about? Like logical assertions, probabilities assertions are about possible words. What is the possibility? We are talking about that. Whereas logical assertions say which possible words are strictly ruled out. Probabilistic assertions talk about how probable the various words are. The probability theory, in probability theory, the set of all possible words are called a simple space. So in a probability there is a sample space. The sample space is nothing but the set of all possible words. The possible words are mutually exclusive and exhaustive. Now the two possible words cannot be the case and one possible word must be the case. For example, if we are about to roll two distinguishable dice, there are 36 possible words to consider. That's 1, 1, 1, 2, like this, up to 6. Now the question is how the fully specified probability model is defined. Now we can define like this. Now a fully specified probability model associates a numerical probability P omega with each possible word. The basic axioms of probability theory says that every possible word has a probability between 0 and 1. So always the probability can be either 0 or 1. So we can define the probability model by using this equation. Now the next point is the language of proposition in probability assertions. Now the variables in probability theory are called as random variables and their names begin with the uppercase letters. Now we are going to represent the variables as the domains. Now in the dice example, total and dice 1 are the random variables. Every random variable has a domain. Now the domain is a set of possible values it can take on. The domain of total of 2 dice is a set of 2 from 2 up to 12, and the domain die 1 is from 1 to 6. A Boolean random variable has a domain true or false. Now here the double is equal to. By convention, proposition of the form A is true are abbreviated simply as A, while A is equal to false is abbreviated as negation of A. Now we say that the P statement defines a probability distribution for the random variable whether. The P notation is also used for conditional distribution. P, X or Y gives the value of P, X is equal to I and Y is equal to P, X is equal to X, I or Y is equal to Y, J for each pair of I and J. For continuous variables, it is not possible to write out the entire distribution as a vector because there are infinitely many values. Instead, we define the probability that a random variable takes on some value x as parameterized function of x. For example, so p of noon temp is equal to x implies uniform of this. Now this is called as probability density function. The probability density function differs in the meaning from discrete distributions, saying that the probability density is uniform from 18C to 26, meaning that there is 100% chance that the temperature will fall somewhere in the 8 degree Celsius wide region and a 50% chance that it will fall in any 4 degree Celsius wide region. Now the next point is probability axioms and their reasonableness. The basic axioms of probability equation implies certain relationship among the degrees of beliefs and that can be accorded to logically related propositions. For example, we can derive the familiar relationship between the probability of proposition and the probability of its negation. So the equations are like this. We can also derive the well-known formula for the probability of disjunction, sometimes called inclusion-exclusion principle. So this will be the formula. Now here is some diagrammatic representation of the figure that agent 1 and agent 2. So here is the proposition and what will be the belief, here will be bet and what will be the stake. So this figure represents, because the agent 1 has inconsistent beliefs, agent 2 is able to devise a set of bets that guaranteed loss for agent 1, no matter what the outcome of A and B. Now the next point is inference using full joint distribution. Now in this section we are going to describe a simple method of probabilistic inference, that is the computation of posterior probabilities for query proposition given observed evidence. We use the full joint distribution as the knowledge base from which answers to all the questions may be derived. Along the way, we introduce several useful techniques for manipulation equations involving probabilities. So here we are going to talk about the probability inferences. Now we are going to represent a full joint distribution for Kutke caveat and catchword. So here is the domain. Domain consists of three Boolean variables. So these are the three Boolean variables, and the full joint distribution is 2 into 2 into 2. So here we have to find out that the probabilities in the joint distribution sum to 1 as required by axioms of probability. Now notice here also that given an equation gives us the direct ways to calculate the probabilities of any proposition, simple or complex. Simply identify those possible worlds in which the proposition is true and add their probabilities. For example, there are 6 possible words in which the cavity conjunction Kutke holds. So probability of cavity conjunction Kutke is equal to like this. So these are the probabilities and this is the combination of the probabilities. Next point is independence. Now let us expand the full joint distribution as shown in the previous figure by adding 4th variable, that is weather. So the full joint distribution then becomes probability of Kutke, catch, cavity and weather, now which has 4, 2 into 2 into 2 into 4, that is 32 entries. Now it contains 4 editions of the table shown in the figure above, one of each kind of weather. What relationship do these editions have to each other and to the original three variable table? We can represent like this. So probability, this is the probability and this is again second probability and how they are going to relate it. Now this will be like equation for the relation. Now unless one is in the dietary business, one should not imagine that one's dental problem influences the weather. And for indoor dentistry, at least it seems safe to say that weather does not influence the dental variables. Therefore, the following assertions seem reasonable. So probability cloudy or Kutke, catch and cavity. So either can be Kutke or cloudy. So the probability will be the cloudy. Now here is a diagrammatic representation of entire problem. Two examples of factoring a large joint distribution into a smaller distribution using absolute independence. So So this is the domain. Domain contains the cavity, tooth care, weather and catch. It leads to a decomposition of the cavity, tooth care and catch or weather. So the weather and dental problem are independent and coin flips are independent. Next point is Bayes' rule and its use. We define the product rule as below. So the probability of A disjunction B is equal to probability A or B and probability B. And probability of A disjunction B can be defined as probability B or A and probability of A. So we can write equations like this. Now this equation is known as Bayes' rule. The more general case of Bayes' rule for multivalued variable can be written as probability of notation as follows: probability of P or X. So it is going to tense variable like this. Now when we are going to apply the Bayes' rule, the simple case will be as below. On the surface, Bayes' rule does not seem very useful. It allows us to compute the single term probability of B or A in terms of three terms: probability of A or B, probability of B and probability of A. That seems like two steps backward, but the Bayes rules is useful in practice because there are many cases where we do have a good probability estimates for these three numbers and need to compute the fourth. So that case the Bayes rule becomes probability of cause or effect, which will be probability of cause or effect into probability of cause divided by probability of effect. The conditional probability, that is probability of effect or cause, quantifies the relationship in the causal direction, whereas probability of cause or effect describes a diagnostic direction. In a task such as medical diagnosis, we often use the conditional probabilities on causal relationship. That is, the doctor knows that symptoms are a disease and want to derive a diagnosis, probability of either a disease or a symptoms. Next point is the Wampus World Revisited. Already we have seen the Wampus problem. It is one kind of a game where we want to kill the Wampus. Now we are going to combine the ideas of the chapter of probabilistic reasoning, and we are going to talk how we are going to solve this by using probabilistic reasoning. Now the first step is to identify the set of random variables we need. As in the proportional logic, we want a one boolean variable, that is Pij, for each square, which is true if and only if square ij is actually contains a pit. Now this is the dynamic representation. We are starting with the position 1, 1, and we are going in a forward direction. After finding a bridge in both 1 and 2 and 2 and 1, the agent is stuck. There is no safe place to explore. Division of squares into known, frontier and other. So we are going to make the divisions. We also have boolean variables Bij. There is true if and only if ij is busy. We include these variables only for observed squares. Now this will be the probability. So how we are going to find out the equations? The next step is to specify the full joint distribution. So distribution will be like this, and applying the product, we are going to make the probabilities of the equations like this. Now, this is the diagrammatic representation of constraint model for the frontier variables. That is P11 and P31. These are the values, or these are the box positions showing P, that is frontier for each model. Three models are there, with P13 is true, showing two or three pits. Now the expression probability of B or known and P13, that is position and frontier, is 1 when the frontier is consistent with bridge observation and 0 otherwise. So here we are going to make the representation of either 0 or 1, that is always the probability is either 0 or 1. So we are dividing into the probabilities of 0 and 1. Now when it is 0 and when it is 1, when there is an unknown or there is a B and there is a frontier at the position 1, 3, that is first one, third column and frontier, then there is a probability of 1 when the frontier is consistent with the bridge observations. and if it is not in the bridge observations, it is considered as a zero. Thus, for each value of P13, we sum over the logical models for the frontier variables that are consistent with the known fact. So this will be the probability and this will be the approximate value. Now we can summarize that roughly a pit with a 31 probability, a similar calculation which readers might wish to perform on the shows that contains a pit with a 86 probability. So this was the discussion about how we are going to use a Wampus world in the probabilistic manner. In the next session, we are going to see the probabilistic reasoning, how we are going to make the reasoning in terms of probability. Here we are in this chapter, we are going to find out the probability and applying how the probabilities, possibilities by using one kind of game, that is Wampus world. We have seen the bias rules also and how it is going to implement it. We have seen the independence also. We have seen the inference using the full joint distribution also. So this was the end of this chapter. In the next chapter, we are going to see the probabilistic reasoning. Thank you.